Skater Boy Alex here to pop shoving a new video in your face. This channel is a lot about celebrating video games, but this video is going to be a little sad because I'm going to be mourning a video game. That game is Skate 4 and why we shouldn't want it anymore. If you're a super cool gamer like me, then I'm sure you've played games like Tony Hawk, SSX, maybe even some Jet Set Radio. Then when your nerd self graduated to the 7th console generation, I bet you hippie flipped straight into a game known as EA Skate. Back when EA wasn't literally Satan, they managed to publish some of the best and unique game franchises of the generation. Dead Space, Mass Effect, and many more that I'm way too lazy to list. But none of those games have fans pestering for a sequel on Instagram more than Skate. We've all seen it or even participated. Every post on EA's Instagram account has been bombarded with comments demanding Skate 4 to this day, and I'm right there with you. I would love to see a Skate 4 on the current or next gen consoles, and maybe even on PC. I could see it having a much larger open world, incredible visuals, and a much more robust and less clunky online. A skateboard wear and tear mechanic on the hard difficulty, like how in Tony Hawk where your board would snap, or an enhanced creative park feature, better create a skater as well. There's huge potential for a skate game with much better hardware, and if done properly, it would easily be the best and only AAA skateboarding game to exist on the market. But you read the title, and I know what you're thinking. Alex, you said you wanted a Skate 4, so why are you telling me we shouldn't want it? This is the part where I crush your dreams, because I've already crushed mine. If you have seen EA's track record, then you already have your answer. First of all, it would inevitably be crushed under the weight of its hype, just like Half-Life 3 would. Not only that, this isn't Valve we're talking about, this is EA. Could you imagine the mechanics of a new skate game? Visually, it would be stunning, but the world would be a lifeless shell of monetization. Gear wouldn't be unlocked through campaign progression, it would be unlocked through backpacks, the skater version of loot boxes. The best gear would have the lowest chances, so you'd have to fork up the cash to get that sick legendary skateboard that you wanted, if you didn't want to wait. And you know, EA, if you're watching, you're welcome, and I'm sorry everybody else. Cut me a check afterwards. In the eyes of EA, loot boxes would not only be a requirement to fund a new skate game, but I also believe this would be the worst game to see them in. Skateboarding represents personal expression, a little bit of rebellion, and most importantly of all, freedom. Oh, you want to express yourself? Too bad, loser. You gotta pay up to get those Tims. I'm noticing a trend here. I recently made a first impressions video on Apex Legends, and I made the prediction that Titanfall 3 would just be called Titanfall with the year in parentheses using the Frostbite engine. I think the exact same thing would happen to Skate. It would just be called Skate 2021 or whatever year it comes out. We would all complain at the quality of the game. It would be forgotten really quickly, and we'd all go back to waiting for Skate 1 and 2 on Xbox One or a full remaster of all three games. And worst of all, it would probably be broken at launch. The only upside to the new EA model is that there wouldn't be DLC packs to separate the player base. I know this video seems really depressing, but there's a bigger light at the end of the tunnel that even Skate 4 couldn't touch. Games like Session and Skater XL are getting a lot of publicity, and Session is looking really great since it's getting an Xbox One release as well. I just wish that they weren't early access titles. There's also always hope for the remaster of Skate 1 and 3 and Skate It on current gen consoles and even PC. So to sum it all up, I think Skate 4 is just Half-Life 3 at this point. But that doesn't mean we should give up hope. It just means we should be asking for Skate Remastered instead. So what are you guys thinking? Are you guys still holding out for Skate 4? Or do you guys got Session and Skater XL or the Skate Remastered on your mind? I'm personally really excited for Session, but obviously a Skate Remastered would be a day one buy for me as well. I hope you enjoyed this video. Like and subscribe if you did. I'll see you guys in the next video. Stay hashtag blessed.